Greetings. Welcome. In this session, we will focus on the topic basic concepts in equipment maintenance and some details about the construction equipment maintenance. I am Dr. G. Sankara, Professor and Head of the Department, RR Institute of Technology. Introduction. Whenever a machine is used, it is subjected to wear and tear because of its operations, its usage in different terrains, different conditions, and also it is subjected to different environmental conditions. Hence, proper attention should be given to protect the machine and its components from undue wear and tear, and thus protect them from failures. A proper attention means what? It means lubrication, cleaning, timely inspection, and systematic maintenance. Maintenance of a machine means efforts directed towards the upkeep and the repair of that machine to keep it in good, efficient operating condition, and to attend to its repairs is called the maintenance. Every machine requires repairs even if it is best designed. Hence, the repair must be done at such a time when it may have least disruptions. That means when machine may be repaired when it is not being used, or its use may be postponed without affecting the production of the equipment or the project. Therefore, checking of the machine is generally done when it is not in operation, so that the defect, if any, can be immediately and easily rectified without causing extensive damage. In this way, we say that maintenance is responsible for the smooth and efficient working of an equipment and helps in improving its productivity. It also helps in keeping the machine in a state of maximum efficiency with economy. Success of any organization largely depends on proper selection of persons engaged for the operation work. Production in the concern depends largely on the maintenance of the plant and heavy equipment and other equipments. Hence, the organization of the maintenance wing should be such that a proper maintenance and overhaul, etc., can be done economically and effectively. For this purpose, many large companies maintain a separate maintenance management wing or a department, and it is generally given an important position in the project as well as in the organization. Let us discuss the objectives of maintenance. What are the objectives of maintenance? Why we should carry out maintenance? To maximize availability of plant, equipment, and machinery for productive purposes. To extend the lifespan of plant, equipment, and other facilities by minimizing their wear and tear. That means to extend its lifespan, as well as during the lifespan also, it should be in operating conditions all the time. These are the basic objectives. Other objectives are to ensure operational readiness of equipment at all times, to reduce the cost of loss to production due to breakdown. If it is not properly maintained, suddenly it may undergo malfunction or stop working. In that case, if it happens in the middle of the production work, what it is doing, then the production will be affected, it will be postponed, and sometimes it may cause an immense loss to the organization. Hence, to reduce the cost of loss to production, due to breakdown, maintenance is required. To provide information to the management on the cost and effectiveness of maintenance, to arrive at an estimate about the maintenance, to ensure safety through regular inspection and maintenance of the plant equipment, other facilities such as compressors, elevators, material handling equipment, etc. Safety of the employees also is very paramount importance to any organization. So a properly maintained equipment will help in enhancing the safety and meeting the safety norms. These are the objectives. Now let us see what are the functions of maintenance or maintenance department. To develop maintenance policies, procedures and standards. So all the details about when we have to do the maintenance, how we have to do, who we have to do, all these things you should develop a policy, procedure and standard operating procedures and a standard for evaluation of the maintenance. All these things should be developed. To schedule planned maintenance work in consultation with concerned department, because it involves coordination of many departments, production department, project department, financial department. So all these things should be coordinated. So the maintenance should be scheduled in consultation with all these departments. To carry out maintenance, repairs and overhauls, to ensure good operational status and availability. If necessary, arrange training for operators and maintenance workers. We need to have a skilled operators as well as skilled maintenance team. So they should be provided with necessary training, because the technology keeps on changing and they should be update with the technology. To ensure scheduled inspection and lubrication of plant equipment and machinery, to maintain a record of maintenance work, we should maintain the records of the maintained work also. Lubrication of the equipment, plant and machinery should be done periodically. To prepare inventory of spares and other materials needed for maintenance. So maintenance requires replacing some lost or worn out spares. So we should have a storage of those spares, and we should prepare an inventory of those spares and other tools, etc. To control inventory of spares and other materials. To prepare maintenance budget and control it, because budget, you can't spend how much you want for the maintenance. It is also affects the total cost of the project. So you should have a budget, prepare in the beginning, as well as try to complete the work within the budget and keep on reducing the amount of the budget for maintenance. To develop proper management information system about the maintenance activity, to help in selecting process and equipment from maintenance point of view. These are all the functions, main functions. Some more functions can be to control the maintenance team, spares and maintenance schedule, plan, etc. Monitoring and controlling of all failures, so that causes of recurrent failures can be identified and diagnosed. If frequently same type of failures are occurring, then there should be corrective measures or rectification of those faults. Failures shall be identified and diagnosed, and rectification should be carried out. To coordinate with the plant and equipment manufacturers with reference to collection of maintenance information. So the equipment manufacturer also will be having a data about its maintenance. So you should collect this information so that it can save our time, men, material and efforts in maintenance. Spares inventory control for identifying abnormal spares usage. If all the spares may not be
small quantities or may not be small in size. There may be some big in size, there may be very few in the machinery. So that abnormal spares also we should identify and keep a inventory of those in a sufficient quantity, not too high, not too low. To carry out failure analysis by constituting interdisciplinary teams. Failure analysis includes frequency of failure, cost of resultant lost production, and cost of resultant maintenance resources used, etc. All these analysis should be carried out based on the past history of the maintenance as well as based on the information provided by the manufacturer. This analysis will help a great in resolving the maintenance problems. The result of the analysis is useful for corrective maintenance decision making, which is highly helpful to the management. To carry out maintenance cost control through identification of high cost area of maintenance. Similarly, which are all the high cost requires high expenditure maintenance problems should be identified and have a idea how to control those things. Monitoring the trend of maintenance effectiveness and providing information for maintenance decision making. So these are all the various functions of maintenance management, maintenance department, or in general about the maintenance. Then coming to the types of maintenance. Maintenance is generally broadly classified into two types. One is breakdown maintenance, another one is preventive maintenance. What is breakdown maintenance? Let us see first. In the first case of maintenance, that is breakdown maintenance, repair is done after the breakdown occurs. While in case of preventive maintenance, that is in the second case of maintenance, it is done on the basis of production prediction or on the basis of periodical checking. Now let us go in a bit detail about the breakdown maintenance. This is similar to if you are using your own transport vehicle like car or any two wheeler or etc., or if you are going by a public transport also, sometimes you will see that the your vehicle suddenly stop because of failure of the, it can be failure of engine, it can be damage of the tires, etc. In the middle of the road or on the side, you see parked vehicles which are waiting for a mechanic to make it repair. This is called breakdown maintenance. It occurs mainly two reasons. One is unexpected or unpredictable failure or malfunctioning of the various parts or components of the machinery or the equipment, which cannot be prevented. And second is due to gradual wear and tear of the parts, which can be eliminated to a large extent by regular inspections known as preventive maintenance. So it can, the damage of the some spare parts which can occur because of their wear and tear of the usage and environmental conditions, so suddenly they may stop functioning. And these are generally the reasons for the breakdown maintenance. So in this case, the equipment or machinery or the vehicle will stop operating and comes to a standstill. In breakdown maintenance, defects are rectified only when the machine cannot perform its function any longer and the production department is compelled to call on the maintenance engineers for the repairs. After repairing the defect, the maintenance engineers do not attend the machine again until another failure occurs. So if you are having planning only breakdown, we will attend only it stops functioning, then
you'll have a engineers, or sometimes you'll have, instead of having your own department, you can hire some experts, attend to the problem, and once it starts operating, you will forget it again, still it collapse or breakdown. So this is the breakdown maintenance. In this type of maintenance, repair shall have to be done on failure. Thus, it may disrupt the whole production if it is performing an important work. This method is much expensive, also due to increase of depreciation cost, payment to idle operators, overtime to the maintenance staff for doing the emergency repairs, and idling of matching equipment. So it has so many disadvantages, this breakdown appearance, payment of to idle operator. If you are having some mechanics with you who are using that equipment, so once this stops production, so that people who are working on the using this equipment become idle, but still you have to pay them. Then overtime to the maintenance staff, the mechanics which you are attending to this, because this is a breakdown maintenance, you should rectify as early as possible by working extra time. So you have to pay an extra overtime to the maintenance staff because they are attending to the emergency repairs and idling of matching equipment. So related, not only if this equipment stops production, the equipment which other equipment which are in the sequence previous to this equipment, which supplies the material or which sequence of actions to this machine, they will become idle. And similarly, the equipment which are in the sequence after this equipment or which receive the materials etc. from this equipment, they also become idle. So their operators become idle. So entire production cycle becomes standstill. So you have to pay all of them, and you will incur a lot of loss in this case. So this is very highly expensive, the breakdown maintenance. Now coming to the preventive maintenance. It is also called as planned maintenance, scheduled maintenance, systematic maintenance, etc. Objectives of preventive maintenance. It is an extremely important function for the reduction of maintenance cost and to keep the good operational condition of equipment and hence increase the reliability. Prevention maintenance aims to locate the sources of trouble and to remove them before the breakdown occurs. It is based on the idea prevention is better than cure. Scheduled maintenance is always economical than unscheduled breakdown maintenance. Best safeguard against costly breakdown is to inspect, to lubricate, and to check up the equipments as frequently as possible. So this comes under the inspection or checkups. To take full use of the equipment, to maintain it in reliable condition, necessary measures should be taken to prevent overloading, dampness, negligence, and misuse of machines. So to prevent that breakdown, these things should be regularly checked in the workplace, like the dampness, overloading, negligence, and misuse of the machines. Frequency of inspection should be decided on the basis of the importance of the machine, wear and tear of the machine, and its delicacy. Thus, periodic inspection or preventive maintenance or checking helps to find out the reasons leading to breakdown to rectify them. When they are in minor stages, the repair can be done when one wants to do it, when it has the least effect on the production schedule. Further, this repair requires lesser time as compared to that of the breakdown repair. Thus, downtime or idle time is reduced by doing preventive maintenance. We can reduce the shutdown periods to a minimum. Then To keep the machine, another objective is to keep the machine in proper condition so as to maintain the quality of the product. So if there is some defect or malfunctioning of the equipment, the products coming out of that equipment also may not be in quality. So to maintain the quality of the products, we should keep the machine in proper condition. Another objective is by minimizing the wear and tear, preserve the value of the equipment. Then another objective is to ensure for the safety of the workers. Some more objectives are to keep the plant at the maximum production efficiency. To achieve all the above objectives with the most economical combination. Again, we should see the cost factor also so that it will not be not too highly prohibitive for the company or for the project. So these are all the objectives. Now let us discuss the functions or elements of preventive maintenance. They can be listed as inspection or checkups. In this case, crews carry out both the external and internal inspection. It is an essential function of the preventive maintenance program. In external inspection means to watch for and detect defects from abnormal sound, vibration, heat, smoke, etc. when machine is in operation. So this is the external inspection means when machine is in operation, if somebody observes any difference in its operating sound, its vibrations, any extra high or low heat it is generating, or smoke, excess quantity of smoke or color of the smoke, etc., indicates there is some problem with the equipment. So if it is observed these things, then it is time to undertake the preventive maintenance. This comes under external inspection. In case of internal inspection means inspection of internal parts such as gears, bushes, bearings, tolerance in the parts, etc. during the period when the machine is under pre-planned shutdown. So in this case, the machine is temporarily given rest, or generally when a weekly off Sunday or Saturday, or stopping the work for one hour early in the evening or early in the morning. So with some pre-planned schedules, the internal parts are checked for their proper condition. This is called internal inspection. This frequency of inspection should be decided very carefully, because too less inspection may cause breakdown. If it is neglected, preventive maintenance, it will lead to the breakdown, as defects could not be traced out and rectified immediately. If you are undertaking too much inspection too frequently, means wastage of machine time and labor productivity. So as I told, to do the internal inspection, you need to stop its production. So if you are undertaking too much frequently, machine time is lost and the productivity of the labor working on the machine also will become idle and unused. Hence, frequency should be decided on the basis of past experiences and accordingly. Anyway, this we will see once again in the economics, later. Then servicing also is an element of preventive maintenance, function of preventive maintenance. What is servicing? Mechanical components like gears, bearings, bushes and other friction surfaces give good performance for long periods when they are systematically lubricated. Systematic lubrication means the application of right type of lubricant at the right time, at the right place and in right quantity. So lubrication plays a very important role in the proper functioning of the equipment. So it should be taken out frequently. For servicing, a schedule should be prepared and following strictly
Servicing includes cleaning, lubrication, cooling, and checkups. Next function is planning and scheduling. Every preventive maintenance work should be pre-planned in detail on the basis of the analysis done on the past records. A scheduled program thus prepared should be followed strictly. Thus, program should be in detail specifying the points requiring daily, weekly, monthly, half-yearly or yearly attention. So some parts may require daily attention, and if it is in the site, the operator should do these checkups. Then weekly, some checkup is required every week. Some inspection and maintenance is required monthly. Some may require half yearly, or some can be postponed for a yearly checkup. So these should be properly identified, and properly all these tasks should be planned and scheduled in an efficient manner. Recommendations of the equipment manufacturer should also be kept in view in preparing the schedules, and for decision making about all this information should be informed to the management. Then next important element is records and analysis. Good record keeping is essential for good preventive maintenance, as it helps in forecasting maintenance. For this purpose, following records are generally maintained. What are they? Operation manual, you should have an operation manual, how the machine functions. Then maintenance instruction manual. Then history cards and history registers. Spares procurement register. Inspection register. Log books. Defects register. All this information related to the maintenance should have a record. So with the help of these records, it is possible to identify the cause for major repetitive failures and rectification, so as not to repeat these failures frequently or so early next time. These records help the maintenance to take decisions and plan maintenance. Then training of maintenance also is very important, because every equipment will have a different components, different functions, different parts, different technology, etc. So for the success of preventive maintenance, a sound training is essential for maintenance personnel. Hence, the technicians and supervisors are trained to carry out maintenance, inspection and repairs in a systematic way. Then another important element is storage of spare parts. Spare parts play an important role in doing a proper maintenance. Machine remains idle for want of spare parts for a considerable time, and thus it results in considerable loss of production. It can happen sometimes. Hence, it is essential to keep the spare parts so as to avoid loss of production. But the judgment and experience of high order is required for deciding the number of such parts, as storage of large number of parts will mean blocking of capital. The level of spare parts must be determined by considering different factors such as source of supply, delivery period, availability of that spare parts in the market. So this is a very critical function, keeping the right quantity, right time, right spare parts in the storage area or in the garage or in the organization. Because too many spares waste your capital and storage space, and too less can spoil the production of the equipment. So a judicious judgment is required in maintaining the storage of spare parts. So these are all the various functions or elements of preventive maintenance. Then let us see the advantages of preventive maintenance. It has particular advantages over the breakdown maintenance, because we have seen breakdown maintenance affects the production mainly. the work will come to a standstill and all related equipment and operators will become idle. So these can be avoided by taking preventive maintenance. So what are all the important advantages of an efficiently planned and well executed preventive maintenance program? They are reduction in the production downtime. So production idle time, production downtime can be reduced considerably. Lesser overtime payment for maintenance proposal. Personal. For maintenance personnel, because preventive maintenance is a scheduled maintenance, they can undertake in the regular hours. They need not do any extra overtime. Lesser number of standby equipments are required. So same equipment can be shut down temporarily for preventive maintenance, and again production can be done on the same machine. Whereas if you are not planning preventive maintenance, in case of breakdown maintenance happens, then to keep the production cycle running, you should have a standby equipment. So it for which equipment will stop functioning, we don't know. So it requires so many standby equipment for our critical equipment. That can be avoided if you undertake a preventive maintenance. Less expenditure on repairs. Due to planned spare parts replacement, lesser spare parts are needed to remain in store at all times. Greater safety to employees because of reduced breakdown. So these are all the some of the advantages of preventive maintenance. So as we discussed earlier, the frequency of the maintenance, preventive maintenance, plays very important role in decision making because it affects the cost of the maintenance. Let us see how here. If you see the preventive, this is the a graph showing the various cost involved and the effect of the breakdown maintenance and preventive maintenance on the total cost of maintenance. So on the x-axis it is maintenance commitment or maintenance schedule. On the y-axis it is the indicates the cost involved. If you see the preventive maintenance graph, it goes on increases with increasing the maintenance frequency. If you are undertaking very frequently the maintenance, the cost will increase. So it reflects the increase in the preventive maintenance cost increases with number of frequency of the maintenance, preventive maintenance. Then another curve if you see, which is breakdown maintenance cost, as if you with the increase in the preventive maintenance cost, the breakdown maintenance cost will come down. It is indicated in the dark blue color. So if you undertake the preventive maintenance, then breakdown maintenance cost can be reduced because preventive maintenance keeps the equipments in good operating condition. That means if you keep on doing the preventive maintenance regularly, but the overall cost will affect, which is indicated in the red line above. So if preventive maintenance costs are paced at some regular intervals, it will in the beginning, in the earlier part, if you see, it will reduce the total cost. But if the frequency is increased too much, it overtakes the cost of breakdown maintenance, and after some frequency the total cost starts rising. As indicated in the red curve, it indicates rising. So an optimum frequency should be maintained where the total cost is at the lowest point, which is projected with a black line to the x-axis. So that point is the optimal point, lowest cost maintenance policy. So you should take this every equipment, every company, every organization in their, based on their fleet
bear importance of their equipment. This they should prepare a chart and decide what is the optimum frequency of maintenance is required, because it helps in controlling the cost of maintenance and cost of production, overall cost of the project. So this is the economics of the maintenance. So these are all the broadly two types of maintenance we have seen so far. One is the breakdown maintenance, another one is the preventive maintenance. Besides this, there are other terms used, and some of them are advanced concepts which came up recently in the maintenance management concepts. Corrective maintenance. Corrective maintenance is again a part of the preventive maintenance. In this case, as you see, once you buy a vehicle, your dealer will give you a schedule for preventive maintenance, maybe once in 3 months, once in 4 months, like that. For first 2 years, he will give the schedule. So whether it is breakdown or not, you go to the dealer, because some of the services are free also. So you go to the dealer, get it done so that your vehicle is in good condition. So once you go there, he may ask you some questions. In addition to the, he will check up the regular parts and cleaning and all those. He will ask you, is there any specific problem you are facing with your equipment usage? So if you say, yeah, there is some problem with the sound, there is some problem with some part, there is some damage with, so that in that preventive maintenance schedule, the mechanic will try to attend to that specific failure or specific problem and try to corrective action taken and rectify that particular specified failure or fault in the equipment. So this is called corrective maintenance. It will focus on the problematic or failure, particular failure of the any particular component, along with the regular preventive maintenance. This is broadly a preventive maintenance. While carrying out repairs on an equipment, either some minor modification work is done so that it may work a little better than it was working before breakdown, or some remedial actions is introduced in such a way that it does not happen again. Such works fall under the category of corrective maintenance. Whereas the preventive maintenance is responsible for the cleaning, the equipment, lubrication to prevent wear, programmed replacement, and also indirectly deals with condition monitoring, failure statistics, and adjustment to limit wear, corrective maintenance deals with normal repairs, modification to reduce requirement of maintenance, and overhauls in addition to breakdown repairs. Then next is condition based maintenance, CBM, also called as condition monitoring. It is also a part of preventive maintenance. In this case, some indicators will indicate the condition of the equipment. So based on that input parameters, the maintenance is taken up. This is also used along with preventive maintenance. In this system, health of the equipment is regularly monitored and recorded in the form of a mechanical vibrations, noise, acoustic, thermal emissions, changes in chemical composition, smell pressure, relative displacement, etc. So these are all regularly, periodically monitored by the maintenance department for various equipment, these parameters. So this is actually a diagnosis of the detection of faults. Vibrations and noise, smoke, etc. are most valuable signals. Conditions monitoring can be applied in the following three ways. It can be done in three ways. Qualitative checks based on its look, its sound and feel through simple inspection. This is generally done as a simple inspection, may be done daily either by the operator or by the maintenance department. Its look, sound and feel through. Then condition checking by measuring some parameters regularly, maybe once in 3 days or once in a week, checking the various parameters indicated above. Then trend monitoring is done by making measurements and plotting them in order to detect gradual departure from a norm. Then the trend of the other important critical parameters is monitored and they are tabulated, calculated, sometimes plotted and checked, evaluated with respect to the standard norms. And if there is any deviation from the norm, then it indicates the condition is getting changed. It requires maintenance. So condition based maintenance is concerned with extracting information from the machine to indicate its condition and to enable them to be operated and maintained with safety and economy. The use of condition monitoring and non-destructive testing is the part of the maintenance strategy with the aim to maximize the availability of the equipment. Then the advanced maintenance method is predictive or diagnostic maintenance. In this case, it is possible to predict the failure of the machine much before it occurs, so that maintenance staff can prepare themselves and arrange necessary parts required and skilled manpower for repairs to put the machine back on work. So various parameters are observed and they are projected into the future using various nowadays we have computers, softwares, etc. to do this prediction. Future performance of the equipment based on the present state of its various conditions, conditions and parameters. Future when the equipment likely to get damaged or likely to undergo breakdown maintenance. All these things can be with reasonable accuracy, they can be predicted and a decision can be taken by the management to arrange for the required spare parts, required tools, required manpower to attend to that before that breakdown occurs. So this is called a predictive or diagnostic maintenance. So these are all the various methods of maintenance of the any heavy machinery including construction equipment. Now let us see some specific details about the construction equipment maintenance. Construction equipment maintenance, because these most of these equipments are a mobile equipments, they will be working in the site, not at a particular centralized factory location. They will be working in different places at different points of time, and they are all, most of them are mobile equipment. So they require a different type of strategy to undertake the maintenance. So what are the various ways here? Maintenance at a central place and maintenance at the work site by using mobile servicing units. So maintenance is undertaken either at the central place, at a factory, the organization or company will arrange a central garage where all the spare parts, tools, the men required for the maintenance, all are located. Once every frequently the equipment is brought there and the preventive maintenance is done there. This is called maintenance at the central place. But if the equipment which is in operation may be a far off place from the central place, from the company site, then whereas large projects equipments are distributed over a large area, they prefer in that case maintenance at work site using mobile units is preferred. So the required spare parts, tools and men will go to the work site, and because the machine bringing to the work site may not be possible because of various reasons like the accessibility, like the time it takes, like the cost involved, like the permits it require, all these things, because it prevents the regular movement of the equipment to the central place. So in that case, the maintenance is undertaken at the work site using mobile units. So, and in case of construction equipment, the maintenance includes following aspects: servicing, field repairs and inspection of equipment. So servicing includes cleaning, cooling, lubrication, checkups, etc. Mobile servicing trailers having facility to store all the oils and lubricants with pumps, grease guns, air compressor, water tanks, etc. are employed to attend the equipment at work site. Field repairs. A field maintenance workshop should be established to cater for day-to-day needs of the entire fleet of the equipments working in the work area. It should have sufficient space for keeping field stores and tools, and should be supplied with electric power, water, servicing station and compressed air. Workshop should be equipped with benches, vices, handrails, grinder jaws, tire repair facilities, welding equipment, gantry crane and a blacksmith shop, etc. These are all the some of the operations and tools required to attend the repairs of the construction equipment in particular. Necessary machine tools like small lathe, pillar drilling machine, etc. are provided in a separate machine shop or in a mobile workshop mounted on a truck. This workshop helps to carry out minor repairs in the equipment. Then inspection of equipments also will be carried regularly. Equipment should be inspected at regular specific intervals to detect faults which can be rectified in time to avoid breakdown. The purpose of the inspection of equipment by the inspection crew is to bring into light about defects in operation, changing adjustments, wear and tear, cracks or any other indication for likely breakdown in near future. If the defects are of minor nature, it can be rectified by the inspection crew at the work site itself. Otherwise, equipment has to be repaired in workshop. So inspection is carried out to find out whether any additional extra maintenance is required or regular routine maintenance is sufficient, whether it can be undertaken in the site or whether it needs the equipment to be taken to the central place. All these things should be decided by through inspection of the equipment. And also, it is very important to decide when to inspect, how to inspect, what to inspect. Inspection covers all important components, including, so during inspection, all the following will be checked: battery, electric line, fuel supply line, water cooling system, tires, wire ropes, engine sound, color of exhaust, oil pressure, engine cooling, water temperature, working of brakes, clutches, cutting edges, hydraulic oil, pressure, etc. It must also be thoroughly checked for the abnormal heating, noise and vibration of any moving part. So a scheduled program for each equipment with a checklist is prepared and given to the inspection crew to check all these elements in their inspection. So these are all the various aspects of the maintenance of construction equipment. So in this topic, we have covered the various aspects of the general maintenance of